With the massive infrastructure push of the current administration, the construction industry faces an increased demand for construction materials. One of these materials is aggregates. As of 2021, a total of 26,494 kilometers of roads have been completed, with 2,515 kilometers still in construction. To make this possible, the volume of sand and gravel produced in the country ramped up over the last 5 years. The increased demand for conventional construction materials necessitates the need to identify alternatives. While roads continue to be built and rehabilitated, the disposal of debris from demolished roads has become a growing concern. Previous research shows that debris from concrete roads and buildings may be used as recycled concrete aggregates, or RCA, in the construction of new roads. The use of RCA as material for the base and sub-base of new pavement systems has the potential to lower construction costs while also reducing the use of natural resources in road construction. I am Engineer Maria Silinci Angeles with the Research and Development Division of the Bureau of Research and Standards of the DPWH. Our study, Road Research Project on the Use of Recycled Concrete Aggregates as Base Course Materials, aims to optimize the use of RCA for government projects by developing a local standard specification for its use in DPWH projects. Recycled concrete aggregates can be obtained from the processed concrete pavement or structural concrete. In this study, we use material from a road in Agono, Rizal. The Portland cement concrete pavement has heavily deteriorated with severe wearing and scaling of the concrete surface. The RCA was subjected to the following quality test as required by the DPWH current issuances and specifications for base course material. Grain size analysis determines the particle size distribution of granular soil material. Los Angeles abrasion test measures the degradation of aggregates resulting from a combination of activities, including abrasion, impact, and grinding. The RCA shall have a mass percentage of wear not exceeding 50%. Moisture density relationship is used to determine the maximum dry density and optimum moisture content for the compaction. California bearing ratio values were determined for each mixture in accordance with the ASHTO T190. This method covers the determination of the bearing ratio of the material when compacted and tested in the laboratory by comparing the penetration load of the materials to that of the standard materials. The method covers the evaluation of the effectiveness of the mixture for the base materials. The resulting CBR values lead to an optimum mixture of 90% RCA and 10% binder. Hence, the laboratory outcomes comply with the requirements under Item 201 of the DPWH standard specification. A small-scale pilot trial was then constructed to test RCA's field performance in comparison to the conventional construction materials. In coordination with the DPWH Rizal First District Engineering Office, a two-lane small-scale trial road was constructed at Don Mariano Santos Avenue in Agono, Rizal. It runs 1,034 linear meters, with half being constructed with recycled concrete aggregates and half containing a conventional base material. A portable crusher was utilized in the project to reduce desired aggregate size. This makes the crushing and the blending activity practically done within the vicinity of the project site. This is then followed by the blending of materials based on the results of the laboratory evaluation. A field density test was conducted to check the compacted RCA base using nuclear density apparatus. Relative to conventional base force, RCA-based material is also required to have a field density equal to 100% maximum dry density as determined in accordance with ASHTO T180. This is then followed by a field test using a dynamic cone penetration test. A second small-scale pilot project in a portion of the Halhala Friendship Highway in Rizal was also constructed. If both small-scale pilot trials pass the performance monitoring test and meet the requirements of the department, a standard specification will be made to to standardize the use of recycled concrete aggregates in DPWH road projects.
The increasing volume of plastics in the environment is a cause for global alarm, and our country is a major contributor to this pollution. The Philippines is the third largest source of plastic waste dumped into oceans, just behind China and Indonesia. This non-biodegradable pollutant, when introduced to the environment, causes immense ecological harm. Our country produces 6.2 million kilos of plastic waste every day. This makes plastic waste one of the biggest challenges to sustainability that we must overcome. Recent technological innovation in the field of engineering promises to help in our plastic problem. Research suggests that the use of plastic waste in road construction can improve the performance of asphalt roads. I am Engineer Nielsen T. Compete of the Bureau of Research and Standards of the DPWH. We are currently examining the possibility of using plastic waste in our road construction projects. Our research, entitled Study on the Use of Low-Density Polyethylene Polymer Waste Plastic Bag as Additive or Modifier in Hot-Mix Asphalt, aims to determine the viability of plastic bag waste when used in hot-mix asphalt, specifically the rotting resistance of the modified bituminous mix. As an innovative material for road construction, plastic waste must undergo a 5-stage testing process for product accreditation by the DPWH. The various laboratory and field tests will determine if roads constructed with plastic waste will stand up to the rigors of traffic, weather, and other conditions of daily use. We look at how plastic waste, when blended with bitumen, affects its characteristics at high and low temperatures. We also consider the affordability and availability of materials, as well as the ability of conventional equipment to process the novel materials. We also considered whether the addition of plastic waste affects the emergence of premature failures such as fatigue, longitudinal transverse cracks, rotting, and potholes. For this study, we used discarded plastic bags gathered from dump site in Laguna. The design of hot mix asphalt varies by asphalt type, aggregate gradation, curing condition, additives, method and level of mixing and compaction. Generally, the Marshall method of mix design and other quality control requirements based on the research conducted by the Asphalt Institute and other institutions were carried out to determine the appropriate portion of aggregates, filler, and asphalt content. Based on the results of the optimization, the optimum asphalt content is 5.33% by weight of mix, while the appropriate amount of low-density polyethylene polymer waste plastic bag by weight of binder is 7.39%. The polymer-modified specimens show remarkable results, so a reduction of about 50% rot depth after the rotting resistance test in comparison with the conventional hot-mix asphalt. These results comply with the requirements in the composition and quality of bituminous mixture under the DPWH standard specifications. It is now recommended to construct small-scale pilot trials as the second stage of the product accreditation scheme. We then develop a method to mix plastic bag waste to hot-mix asphalt for plastic road construction. This involves collecting low-density polyethylene polymer waste like dry sandbags from sanitary landfills and shredding the waste using a shredding machine. The aggregate mix is then heated to 160 to 165 degrees Celsius, while the bitumen is heated to 160 degrees Celsius. This prevents weak bonding. The aggregates are then heated to 165 to 175 degrees Celsius. Aggregates are first heated and then mixed for 30 to 65 seconds with an appropriate amount of shredded plastic. The plastic then melts and coats the aggregates. Asphalt is then mixed in until the mixture is homogeneous. The hot mix asphalt with plastic bag waste is laid at 110 to 120 degrees Celsius using typical road construction methods. In January 2020, our team laid down the first asphalt road in the Philippines made with plastic bag waste constructed on a heavy traffic national road. It is a collaboration project with the DPWH through BRS and South Manila District Engineering Office, the implementing office, the Pilotage Trading Construction Incorporated as a supplier of plastic bag waste, and the Redicon Trading and Construction Corporation, the contractor. This is the first small-scale pilot project constructed along Taft Avenue, Manila. It has a total of 293 meters where it is divided into sections. The first section is a hot mix asphalt with plastic bag waste and the other section is conventional asphalt. For this project, a total of approximately 750 kilograms of plastic bag waste was used. In April 2021, the second small-scale pilot trial was constructed along President Quirino Avenue in Manila. It consists of three lanes with 50 millimeter thickness, having a total carriage varying width from 8.6 meters to 10.7 meters. For this project, the thickness of the asphalt pavement is 50 millimeters, and the project site was chosen because it passed the minimum requirements of site validation and condition survey of the department with the consideration of existing traffic conditions as well as the existing surface defects of the pavement. If both small-scale pilot trials pass the performance monitoring test and meet the minimum requirements of the department, a standard specification will be made, thereby allowing the use of plastic bag waste in the construction of asphalt roads in the country. This innovative project promises to be a solution to our country's plastic waste management problem by upcycling plastic into a construction material. Other studies focusing on plastic bottles and other types of plastics for use as modifiers in bituminous mix. Soon, the use of plastic waste in constructing pavements will reduce our dependence on non-renewable resources and lessen the environmental impact of non-biodegradable waste. Further evaluation should be undertaken to assess the long-term performance of field test sections with modified bitumen to strengthen the use of plastic waste for environmentally friendly road construction. We all live on one planet. Let us all act to promote sustainability and use this opportunity not just to protect our country but also to save our Mother Earth. I encourage you, be the catalyst for change. #IninyeroSibil para sa bayan.